Hello friends, welcome to the video lecture series on digital image processing. I am Dr. Alpesh Dafda, and in this 61st video class of DIP, we will study the Hall transform with example of order n is equal to 4 and its implementation in MATLAB. In our previous video class, we understood what is Hall transform, and also we derived the Hall transformation basis function matrix for n is equal to 2, that is a 2 by 2 matrix, and understood different mathematical steps for deriving Hall transformation matrix. So you should refer to previous video class first, that is DIP video class number 60, for better understanding of this video class. And also we will obtain the same matrix in MATLAB, and we will also see that what is the application of Hall transform in image processing in MATLAB. Okay, so let us start. So these are the steps to generate Hall basis matrix for n is equal to 4. What is our aim over here? Our aim over here is to find a 4 by 4 matrix like this, whose different rows are given by k and different columns are given by z. So step 1 is determine the order of n, which is already given. So n is equal to 4. Step 2 is find total number of bits required small n, where small n is equal to log capital N base 2. So small n is equal to log capital N is 4 base 2, 4 is 2 raised to 2, so 2 will come ahead. So 2 into log 2 base 2, and log 2 base 2 is 1. So 2 into 1 will give 2. So here the total number of bits required are 2, that is 00, 01, 10 and 11. Next step is to find P and Q, where P is given by 0 to n minus 1, that is 0 to small n is 2, which we have obtained, 2 minus 1, that is P is in between 0 and 1, that means P is equal to 0 and 1. And if P is equal to 0, then it is given that Q is equal to 0 or Q is equal to 1. So when P is equal to 0, there are two conditions: when P is equal to 0, Q is equal to 0, and Q is equal to 1. Next, P is also equal to 1, that is P is not equal to 0, right? So if P is not equal to 0, then Q is in between 1 to 2 raised to P. That is, if P is equal to 1, Q is in between 1 to 2 raised to P. 2 raised to P is 1, that is 1. That means Q is in between 1 to 2, that is Q is equal to 1 and 2. Okay, so when P is equal to 1, Q is equal to 1, and when P is equal to 1, Q is equal to 2. So we have four different combinations of P and Q: 00, 01, 11 and 12. Now for these combinations of P and Q, we need to find out small k, which is the name of our different rows of the Hall transformation matrix. So find k, which is total rows given by k is equal to 2 raised to P plus Q minus 1. So for these four different conditions, that is 00, 01, 11 and 12, we will find out k. So if P is equal to 0 and Q is equal to 0, that is the first condition. K is equal to 2 raised to P plus Q minus 1. K is equal to 2 raised to P is 0 over here. So 2 raised to 0 plus of Q. Q is also 0, 0 minus 1. So anything raised to 0 is 1. So 1 plus 0 minus 1, that is 1 minus 1, which is equal to 0. In the same way, we find out value of k for P is equal to 0, Q is equal to 1, P1Q1 and P1Q2 as 1, 2 and 3. So hence we obtain name of our different rows, that is 0, 1, 2 and 3. So K is equal to 0, 1, 2 and 3. The same we will write over here, K is equal to 0, 1, 2 and 3. Now we have to find out the name of different columns, right? That is Z. So step 5, find Z, where Z is given by 0 by capital N, 1 upon capital N up to N minus 1 upon capital N. That is, Z belongs to 0 by capital N is 4, 0 by 4 is 0, comma 1 by 4, 2 by 4 and N minus 1 is 4 minus 1, that is 3 by 4. So Z is equal to 0, 1 by 4, 2 by 4, 3 by 4. And now we have to find out the element values of 4 by 4 matrix. Next, part 1 of step 6, we will find out element values for row k is equal to 0. And we know that if k is equal to 0, at that time p is equal to 0 and q is also equal to 0, we obtain h0 of z is equal to 1 upon root n for all values of z. That is 1 upon root 4, which is equal to 1 upon 2 for k is equal to 0 for all values of z, 0, 1 by 4, 2 by 4 and 3 by 4. That means we will write 1 by 2 for row k is equal to 0. So for k is equal to 0, 1 by 2, 1 by 2, 1 by 2 and 1 by 2. For other values of k, we have to find out the limit using these equations. So next value is k is equal to 1, right? So when k is equal to 1, p is equal to 0 and q is equal to 1. See, when k is equal to 1, p is equal to 0 and q is equal to 1. So we have to first place the values of p and q in these equations and find out the limits for z. So h1 of z is equal to 1 upon root n, that is 1 upon root 4, 2 raised to p by 2. 2 raised to p is 0 over here, so 0 by 2. For z in between q minus 1 upon 2 raised to p and q minus 0.5 upon 2 raised to p. दैट इज क्यू इज 1 माइनस 1 अपॉन 2 रेज टू पी 0, क्यू इज 1 माइनस 0.5 अपॉन 2 रेज टू 0 इज इक्वल टू माइनस 2 रेज टू 0 बाई 2 फॉर जेड इन बिटवीन क्यू माइनस 0.5 अपॉन 2 रेज टू पी एंड क्यू अपॉन 2 रेज टू पी दैट इज 1 माइनस 0.5 अपॉन 2 रेज टू 0 एंड 1 अपॉन 2 रेज टू 0 एंड 0 otherwise. So 1 upon root 4 is 1 by 2, 1 minus 1 is 0, 0 divided by 2 raised to 0 is 0, z, 1 minus 0.5 is 0.5 upon 2 raised to 0, that is 1, right? So 0.5 upon 1 is 0.5, so z in between 0 to 0.5, the value will be 1, minus 2 raised to 0 by 2 is minus 1, for 1 minus 0.5 upon 2 raised to 0, z, 1 upon 2 raised to 0. So 1 minus 0.5 is 0.5 again, and 1 upon 2 raised to 0 is 1. So z in between 0.5 to 1, the value is minus 1 and 0 otherwise. Now we will keep different values of z. That is h1 of first value of z is 0. So h1 of 0 is equal to, we will see where the value of z is 0 over here. So value of z is 0 over the first condition, right? So 1 upon 2 into 1, which is equal to 1 upon 2. So we will write 1 by 2. Next h1 of 1 by 4. So 1 by 4 is 0.25. We will see where 0.25 falls in this limit. 0.25 falls in the first limit. So again, we will write 1 by 2 into 1, that is 1 by 2. H1 of 2 by 4 is equal to, we will see where 2 by 4 is there. 2 by 4 is nothing but 1 by 2. 1 by 2 is 0.5. 0.5 is coming here, but it is less than 0.5. So 0.5 starts from here. So we will write minus 1 by 2. So H1 of 2 by 4 is equal to minus 1 by 2. Next, H1 of 3 by 4. 3 by 4 is 0.75. We will see where 0.75 is falling. 0.75 is falling in this limit, 0.5 to 1. So 1 by 2 into minus 1, which is equal to minus 1 by 2. So we obtain the values for k is equal to 1. That is 1 by 2, 1 by 2, minus 1 by 2, minus 1 by 2. We will write the values over here. 1 by 2, 1 by 2, minus 1 by 2, minus 1 by 2. Next, for k is equal to 2, we will see where k is equal to 2. So k is equal to 2 is when p is equal to 1 and q is equal to 1. So we will write p is equal to 1, q is equal to 1. We will again keep the values of p and q and find the limits. And we find the limits like this. So now h2 of 0, we will see where 0 is falling in this limit. 0 is falling in the first limit, that is 1 by 2 into root 2, which is equal to root 2 by 2. So root 2 by 2 is nothing but 1 upon root 2. So we will write here 1 upon root 2. h2 of 1 by 4, 1 by 4 is 0.25. This is less than 0.25 and 0.25 limit starts from here. So we will write minus root 2 by 2, which is equal to minus 1 upon root 2. So h2 of 1 by 4 is minus 1 upon root 2. Next, h2 of 2 by 4. 2 by 4 is 1 upon 2, which is equal to 0.5. And this is less than 0.5. So 0.5 starts from here, right? So h2 of 2 by 4 is equal to 0. And last one, h2 of 3 by 4. 3 by 4 is 0.75. 0.75 also doesn't fall in this limit, so it will be 0. So h2 of 3 by 4 is equal to 0. Next, part 4 of step 6 is when k is equal to 3. So when k is equal to 3, p is equal to 1 and q is equal to 2. When k is equal to 3, p is equal to 1 and q is equal to 2. So we'll keep the values of p and q and we find out the limits like this. That is root 2 for z in between 1 by 2 to 3 by 4. Minus root 2 for z in between 3 by 4 to 1 and 0 otherwise. So h3 of first value of z is 0. We'll see where 0 is falling. 0 is not falling in this limit, neither in this limit. So we'll write 0. 1 by 4. 1 by 4 is also not falling in this limit because it is starting from 1 by 2. So again, we will get 0 for h3 of 1 by 4. So it is 0. Next, h3 of 2 by 4. 2 by 4 is 1 by 2. 1 by 2 is 0.5. We will see where 0.5 limit is falling. 0.5 limit is falling in this first condition. So we will get root 2 by 2. And root 2 by 2 is nothing but 1 upon root 2. And last condition, h3 of 3 by 4. So 3 by 4 limit starts from here. So minus root 2 by 2, which is equal to minus 1 upon root 2. So we will write the values of last row. 0, 0, 1 upon root 2 and minus 1 upon root 0, 0, 1 upon root 2 and minus 1 upon root 2. So hence, keeping all these values for k is equal to 0, 1 by 2, for k is equal to 1, these values, for k is equal to 2, these values, and for k is equal to 3, these all values, we obtain the Haar transformation matrix like this for n is equal to 4. So if we take out 1 upon root 4 common from this matrix, we obtain our final matrix like this. So this is our final answer of Haar basis matrix for n is equal to 4. Let us implement this in MATLAB. So this is a MATLAB program for generating Haar matrix for n is equal to 4. And this program is similar to the program for n is equal to 2, which we saw in the previous video class. Just the difference over here is that we are also plotting the values of matrix which we are obtaining. Let us run and see the output. So when we run the program, it will ask enter the size of Haar transformation matrix. We enter 4 and we obtain the values like this. And when plotted, these values look like this, where we know that 0 is complete black. So this 0 is complete black, 0.5 will be gray, 1 will be complete white. So 0.5 will be gray. So this is gray, which is 0.5. Minus 0.5 is black. So this is black. These three values will also be black. So these three values are also black. These two values will be black and this will be light gray. So these two are black. This is light gray and this is complete black. This is also complete black. Now let us see the application of Haar transform in image compression. This program we have already seen in JPEG 2000 video class. And that is all for this video class. Thank you very much.